So at this step, we're ready to install our mechanical process connection into our standpipe. Please realize that this standpipe here is super short. This is just for illustrative purposes only. So our mechanical process connection is a 3/4 inch NPT type fitting here. So at this point, we would measure the inside length of the standpipe. We want to leave 0.8 inches of clearance off of the bottom. There's a 1/2 inch insertion length of the cable into the counterweight, and the counterweight's 1.3 inches tall. After you do all the math, basically what you want to do is measure the inside length of the standpipe and then cut the cable 1.6 inches shorter than what the inside length of your standpipe is. Once that's done, your cable will insert into your counterweight, as I said, approximately 1/2 inch. You will use the two set screws to secure the counterweight to the bottom of the cable. Do realize that the counterweight is designed to fit a 4-inch column from the factory. It also has these notches to accommodate a 3-inch as well as a 2-inch column if your column diameter is changed. The column diameter needs to be constant from top to bottom. If it is not constant from top to bottom, you do need to utilize the AKS4100U Coaxial version. So once you've cut the cable length and you've installed the counterweight and clipped the counterweight appropriately if need be, our next step would then be to affix the signal converter with the HMI display on top to the mechanical process connection. Right now we have the dust cap on as if we had installed this, but the plant was still under construction, so we were just waiting for the construction to finish up until we installed the signal converter here. So we would remove the dust cap from the process connection. The signal converter utilizes a copper accepting hole here, and then there's a small copper pin in the process connection. You want to make sure that this is free of dust. You want to make sure that the pin is not bent, and you want to make sure that this hole looks clean and free of obstruction. Once all that's been verified, you'll simply affix this down onto your mechanical process connection until you feel it seat. And once you feel it seat, there is an Allen key here, which would be used to tighten up. This Allen key doesn't have a torque specification. You just want to tighten that down tight enough so that you don't have any free lead way. Here, this would be your standard 1/2 inch type conduit connection, the female pipe thread, where you could insert your wires and then use some sort of cable grip apparatus or something like that to affix your cables internally to the probe. The set screws here on the bottom of the counterweight, those would go to 4 to 5 pound foot of torque.